Und es geht weiter mit Let's Play Fake Grand Order. Ich bin es, Adam Smurfix. Beim letzten Mal sind wir hier entkommen aus der Gefangenschaft hier. Edison hat uns hier gefangen genommen und nur durch... Nein, sie mich blind, Geronimo nimmt mit, wenn das schon so furchtbare Party wiederkommt. Nö. Nehmen wir lieber einen Assess mit. So, wir nehmen mit. Den werde ich denn sehr cool finden. So. Wir konnten aber zumindest entkommen dank der Hilfe von Geronimo. Und er ist ein Rebell, der hier bereit ist, uns zu helfen. Nehmen wir hier beide. Ich finde ISO ist so cool. Und wir hoffen, dass wir jetzt hier entkommen und es schaffen, ja, rauszufinden, was hier eigentlich gespielt wird. Wer ist Geronimo und mit wem arbeitet er zusammen? Fakt ist aber, wir haben beim letzten Mal es geschafft, Kader zu entkommen. Und das ist doch schon mal etwas. Nun gut, starten wir hier mit Kapitel Nummer 6. Rama Gottes Hort. Ja, Rama auch, ich denke mal, das ist der werte Herr, der ganz am Anfang hier im Prolog war und verloren hat gegen den bösen Chu. Good morning, Senpai. Are you awake? Good morning, Mash. Wo sind wir denn hier schon wieder? Schon wieder in so einer Westernstadt. The nap was exactly 3 hours. Rest when you can. That's the spirit. Relax. This is a small town in the west. The residents have already evacuated, likely due to the Celts' fierce attacks. The only people on this land now are those who have come to our side. It's Geronimo! Is he alright? The life of force of servants is incredible. I can't say he's fine, but he's breathing anyway. There's a servant here? Yes, actually we are sheltering the third servant I mentioned here. Ja, stimmt, der hat ja gesagt, wir haben noch drei Verbündete und dann hat er sich verbessert, dass nur zwei sind. Weil wahrscheinlich der Wärter Kammer hier am Anfang so verwundet worden ist, dass sonst keine Hilfe sein wird. Of course, I'm helping you because I want your help in return. But most of all, it's to get a medical treatment. In other words, the spotlight is on me. Not like it matters. If there's a patient who seeks treatment, I will tend to him. Yes, please. And your care, he may yet have a chance. Alright, bring him out. Wieso raus? Sie soll lieber rein zu ihm gehen. Horrible. A part of his heart has been gouged out. I'm shocked he's still alive. Well, endurance is my strong suit. I've never seen a wound like this before, but I can't turn you away. Don't worry, young man. Even if you end up in hell, I'll drag you out. It does sound promising. Can't you be a little more gentle? Do you understand? My heart is crushed. I'm surprised you can't even talk. Anyway, I'll heal you. First, your heart is about to lose all functionality. Because of that, blood cannot circulate properly in your body. I must cut it out. All limbs, I mean. And if possible, I take all organs out, except your lungs too. Wait. Focus on repairing just my heart. No amputation. I cannot lose any means to fight. What are you talking about? There's no greater joy than being alive. As an individual life form who has taken root on this earth, you have a duty to survive, come what may. Just that. Easy for you to say. It's alright. I swear that I'll heal you. I swear it. So, who is he? He doesn't seem like a servant from this country. You mean me? I'm Rama, the great king of Kosala. For more details, read the Ramayana. That's all. Damn it. That really hurts. Frustrating. No matter how much I slow down the speed of an incurring death, I cannot stop it. I won't give up. As long as this body is alive, I fulfill my duty. A nightingale, be more gentle. Who were you fighting that could give such a wound? It was inevitable. After my opponent was Tutelaine, Ireland's strongest hero. Tutelaine? Ah, of course. If Celtic warriors are the enemy, then naturally he would be around. Tutelaine, Ireland's most renowned hero, nicknamed the Child of Light. They say if he aims his land Skellberg, it always pierces his target's heart. Tja, aber sind wir noch Caster, Tutelaine, gell? Wir haben den bekommen, aber die anderen bekommen natürlich den super bösen Tutelaine, der super stark ist.
I suppose it would be difficult to avoid that, even if you are the hero of the Ramayana. More like it's a miracle you're still alive.
Preventing the collapse of our front lines is important, but I want to heal Rama. When I heard about the several concentrating of healing soldiers, I brought you here. Hmm?
That voice from the sky.
Scott, I wipe out every last of them. Du als Caster. Will ich sehen, Mann. Das ist der Fleischtier. Was ist auch schon wieder? Sind Wiverns oder irgend so ein Krampf halt.
Naja, okay, also langsam wird es ja spannend. Wir haben jetzt hier im Endeffekt drei Fraktionen. So wie es aussieht hier, so ein bisschen die Rebellen, wo wir aktuell hier sind, die gegen alles sind. Und zum anderen die Unterdrücker und die Verteidiger. Eine sehr interessante hier Kombination. Und ja, eins ist nur sicher, mit den Zelten, mit den Kelten können wir uns hier leider nicht auf eine Ebene stellen, wenn man so sagen möchte. Denn die sind blöd. Und blöde Dinger mag ich nicht. So. Ist das so cool, Mann. Den habe ich nämlich, der bringt jetzt gegen die, bringt er jetzt nicht viel gegen die Wibberns. Aber generell, gegen normale Servants ist er so ein Monster. Weil ich hatte ihn so auf Level 10, ich habe halt so ein paar schlechte Servants halt in den reingeschmissen, einfach so. Und dann habe ich halt irgendeine Challenge Quest gemacht und da war die war eigentlich Level 30 oder so und der hat sein Noble Phantasm gemacht und die ist einfach von, und die einfach vernichtet den Servant, Mann. Und da musste ich gleich in ihm was reinstecken und jetzt hier wie er so aussieht hier ist der Runin, Mann, das sieht ja so cool aus. Das müssen wir aber so machen. So, das Ding an ihm ist nur, er macht halt sehr wenig Schaden, wenn er nur normale Angriffe hat, aber seine Crit-Damage, oh, und er generiert halt auch so schön Crit-Schaden, Mann. Und in der Party, meine guten Freunde, Mann. Mit Jackie, oh oh. Natürlich noch umso besser. Noch umso besser. Schau ich an, wie er seine Crits jetzt macht. Einfach ohne Ende, Mann. Und wir werden dann gleich zu seinem Noble Phantasm kommen und dann wisst ihr, wieso ich ihn so feiere. Wir sollten unsere Triple Party aus dem machen. Ganz ernsthaft, Mann, ich hab's ja Noble Phantasm so das erste Mal gesehen. Dachte mir, Alter, das ist der Beste überhaupt, Mann. So, und ja, es ist ein sehr cooler Servant. Er macht ordentlich, also, wenn man den gescheit hier levelt, ist das schon geil. So. Habe ich ja gesagt, habe ich mit meinem zweiten Ticket hier von dem Banner gezogen. Das war sehr cool, weil der ja auch ein Storylock-Servant ist und eigentlich nur hier verfügbar ist. Oder halt nächstes Jahr wieder. Also, Leute. Zwei Servants, jo, mach mal den ersten so platt. Schau dir an, der hat ja. Oh, der hat sogar mehr Jesus gehabt. Ja, sehr cool, das habe ich nett. Det habe ich nicht. Bitte greif mir meinen vorderen Iso an. So, komm, macht's den down. Dankeschön. So, ich würde jetzt gerne noch mit Jack-Kombo voll bekommen. Ich weiß nicht, Jack-Karten, die zieht man irgendwie besser. Ich weiß auch nicht, was das ist, aber mit Jack, da zieht man eigentlich die besten, zieht man immer gute Karten. So, Leute, und jetzt ist Insta-Kill-Zeit angesagt. Leute, Triple Noble Phantasm. Triple Noble Phantasm. So, der Skill ist nämlich sehr geil, bringt mir jetzt aber nämlich auf normale Menschen, ne? Macht die Attacke, ich glaube, 50% mehr Schaden oder so, oder keine Ahnung. Das bringt mir jetzt nicht viel, aber okay, die Critical Strength können wir mitnehmen. Also, wie gesagt, das ist wirklich ein richtiger Bosskiller. Was macht eigentlich das denn? Habe ich das letzte dazugelernt. Increase Critical Strength, ach, machen wir doch nochmal, oder? So, und dann ist Iso-Zeit, würde ich mal sagen. Zack. Zack, zack.
お初にお目にかかります。じゃあ、死ね。わしは剣の天才じゃ！
gesagt. Yes. Wie, so, wie man so halbwegs ruhig tut und so wie so eigentlich so abgeklärter Schwert-Samurai hier wirkt. Und dann, ich bin ein genialer Schwertmann. Und dann so, ach, im Blutrausch hier so lacht man. Das ist so geil, man. Ich feiere das so, man. Und wie gesagt, es sieht auch, mal abgesehen davon verdammt cool aus, wie das alles blutet und spritzt. Ist auch verdammt stark gegen menschliche Gegner. Taugt mir sehr. Er verfehlt to ask of all of you. At this rate, the boy's condition isn't going to improve. His heart should have been repaired just now, but more than 10% of it is starting to deteriorate again. A bottomless bucket? Well, not that bad, but without continuous treatment, he will die quickly. This is completely due to my own incompetence. However, I do not want to give up on him. I will not give up on him. This boy wants to live so badly. As long as he possesses the will to live, I will never give up on him. Tell me, how to do this? How to treat him? Tell me what that which I do not know. Doctor, please give us your analysis concerning Rama's injury. Yeah, you don't need to send me any detailed data. I can tell at glance. It's a curse. Removing the curse takes pretended over treatment. The fastest way is to defeat the person who injured him. Gable is said to be a demonic spur or technique wielded by Tutor Lane. In any case, there's no doubt that it was a blow that, if left untended, will destroy the heart. It's basically a miracle that Rama is still alive. Normally, I wouldn't be surprised to see him already dead. Or rather, it's strange he's not dead. Then again, there's Rama, he of the Ramayan, one of the India's two epic poems. If anybody can perform a miracle, it's him. Indeed, you should praise me even more. It's more accurate to say that Rama reversed his state of death through sheer willpower. Basically, the fact that Rama is still alive is an error in the proper cause and effect flow of this world. Dr. Roman, please correct yourself. I do not think it's an error that he is alive. Take your finger off the trigger. Please, just hear what I have to say. As I said earlier, the only way to save him is to eliminate the spear that can the sword cause an effect. However, I can tell how difficult that is even by monitoring events from here over. Besides, Tutelane is certain that there are at least two more servants. Exactly. That's quite literally the war that we are in. I stage a one-on-one attack. Oop, true. Only death would greet me. I'm sorry. Please continue your treatment. You don't need to tell me. Please sit still. However, we do have one thing in our favor. This world state is unstable. Just like how the Celtic warrior continued to be summoned and fight to the death despite their precarious existence. If we can somehow strengthen Rama's existence, we can remove the distortion cast on him, or close to it. Is that similar to how we broke Siegfried's curse when we were in France? Yeah, the best thing would be to make a contact with a servant who knew him when he was alive. Knowing the blueprint of his body when he was alive will likely increase the efficiency of Miss Nightingale's treatment. I know someone, a servant that meets your creature exists in this world. Can't mean Ellie. Simper, stop! Loose lips sink ships, as they say. If you utter that name in a place like this, there's no doubt she will be summoned. Q-fu! Ellie, unfortunately you're quite off the mark. Another was summoned from the same era as me. My wife, Sita. Ich habe jetzt für einen Moment gedacht, er will Elisabeth sagen. Ich habe zwar keine Ahnung, wieso Elisabeth, aber egal. Und wie gleich mir sagt, bloß nicht, sonst kommt sie wieder. I have not seen her yet, but I am certain that she is being held captive somewhere in this world. I crossed blades with Jutulane in order to find her location. I see your wife Sita. You may have dragged her here when you were summoned. If we find her, it may be possible to cure you. I see. At present, Rama is unquestionably the strongest among the servants who have been summoned. Hey, was mit uns? At full strength, he would likely to be equal match for Karna. I want to save him if I can. We must locate his wife Sita as soon as possible. For the purpose, I would alight Nightingale to accompany me. I'd go with you to the ends of the earth. Got a problem?
Truly, I feel reassured, but you don't need the details.
I must honor bond my patients, especially if there's no one besides who can save him.
With that in mind, I believe it is worth seeking a somewhat more efficient nursing method.
Rama, please excuse me. Don't struggle too much.
What? You can carry me so easily? This is how I used to carry Sita.
Isn't that how you carry a princess?
Hey, put me down. What am I to do if my people witness me in the state?
I do not mind. I'm used to violent patients. This way, please. We must also prepare a special belt.
Let me go. Let me go.
That was quick. You are truly the angel feared. I mean, adored by all soldiers.
What's wrong, Doctor? You seem disheartened.
Oh, it's nothing. I mean, Rama's still young, right? Yet he has a wife.
And you're still single at 30, huh?
I can't read your expression, Maxie. Are you sympathizing me or laughing at me?
That is true, but I think it's strange for the Doctor to feel inferior.
Why? Naja, es ist ein indische Gottheit.
No, I mean, I believe the Doctor has, been married previously.
What? Was ein Internet-Idol.
What, Mesh? Why did you have to blatter something like that? But it's true. This one time I saw the Doctor washing his hands and there was a...
I'm sorry, but can we get back to the subject? We're quite pressed for time, too.
Oh, that's right. I apologize. Please continue.
Besides healing Rama, we also need to figure out how to deal with Edison and the Celtic soldiers. I suppose Mr. Mage in the other world has some kind of plan in mind?
Of course, while Maxie is on the front lines, my job is to collect data and analyze it. Recall earlier when we, or Mesh Kirlite rather, fought with Yon McCamel? He muttered something that bothered me.
There are monsters born independently from our queen. Even if we lose a few thousands there, it won't be a problem for us.
In other words, the Celtic soldiers may be able to multiply infinitely. If that's true, normal attacks are useless. Reducing their numbers won't work as a strategy.
That did briefly cross my mind, but it's overwhelming to hear someone say it outright.
Does Edison mechanized infantry follow the same principle?
It's probably fair to say so.
The only way to counter Celtic soldiers who couldn't flinch at loss of thousands is through mass production. As an inventor, Edison did not try to pioneer anything. His talent lay in modifying other people's cutting-edge inventions so that they become more accessible. Without Edison, the telephone, the light bulb, and many other so-called modern conveniences would have developed at an unimaginably sluggish pace.
Moreover, America's pride is its ability to develop war machines on a massive scale.
I see. Perhaps it's necessary for the king of invention to call himself this nation's king. However, it's a troubling idea for us mages. Mass production will lower the value of all mystics.
At any rate, there's only one course of action I can recommend.
Assassination. Use servants to take out both the king and the queen at the same time. Facing them head-on is wasting our resources. It's exactly what they want. With an enemy that can multiply troops indefinitely, the only solution is to target their leader.
Exactly. Well put, Doctor. You must be quite a famous mage. Your voice alone seems unreliable, but that intelligent is anything but.
Even Geronimo has pointed out, I wonder just what's wrong with my image.
Fufu.
Aber du wurdest noch nie von einem Servant gelobt, also ist das doch nicht schlecht.
Excuse me, Doctor. Just said Geronimo hit the nail on the head. Hey, I'm well aware that I'm kind of a wimp, okay?
Alright. To make sure the assassination succeeds, let's unite all servants scattered in different areas. Once we come together, we will make a stand against the Celtic soldiers at Edison. We need to make sure to return this land to the hands of its people.
Also, heißt es nun Verbündete suchen und mit deren Hilfe die beiden Anführer zu ermorden. Doch das wird wahrscheinlich gar nicht mal so einfach. Nun gut, wir versuchen natürlich unser Bestes, sacken hier wieder das Quartz ein. Und dann geht's beim nächsten Mal weiter hier mit Let's Play Fake Grand Order. Bis zum nächsten Mal, haut rein und auf Wiedersehen, ciao.